Hello, and welcome to One Cool Thing, PC Mag's daily show where we show you one cool thing which we are testing out here in the PC Mag Labs. If you are watching us live on Facebook, we have Social Pete here taking your comments and questions. If you are watching us later on YouTube, please like and subscribe and consider coming over to Facebook at 10 a.m. Eastern when we are doing this live show. I'm Sasha Segan. Matt Buzzy is all the way over here. And in between us, the grand barrier that separates us is the Falcon Northwest Talon.
Indeed.
And now the Talon is a very interesting desktop PC because it is one of those PCs that is configurable to pretty much any level. And it looks like we have configured it to the ultimate.
The level, one okay. might say, yeah. Yeah, so this is, you know, built to order as you want. Parts in the case is nice but simple, including the paint job. Falcon Northwest does pretty much any color you can think of. So you can get this nice automotive paint. This is a nice metallic, hope it's coming through nicely on the camera, a nice metallic dark red.
Yeah, it has a shimmer.
Wine color. It definitely has a shimmer. So that said, yeah, ours is spec'd up to quite an expensive build. This is, of course, not something the average person is going to be configuring to. It's just under
$9,000. $9,000. Yeah. And now I have to say, $9,000, and you don't even get to see the inside when the side is on.
Yeah, so super fast, we'll get to that. I'll tell you what all these parts are. It's a nice PC. The case is simple to work with. I don't really have complaints about the design. It's not offensive enough to really put anybody off, which is the case with some high-end computers. But for that much, you know, often you get the custom piping, you get the window where you can see through, you get a lot of case lighting.
You get the weird blood-colored coolant. Yeah.
Yeah. So that is my main, really my only con in my, literally my only con in my review online, obviously aside from the cost. On PCMag.com, the full review is there. It doesn't look the flashiest for the price.
But so this Falcon Northwest Talon, it's all about performance, speed. Not about presentation.
It's all about speed.
So let's talk about these components in here and what kind of performance they're delivering.
So these are two Titan XP cards. These are 12 gigabytes each of VRAM, which is kind of insane. You will not find the XP in most computers anywhere.
Well, I believe at this point you will not find the XP mostly anywhere.
You will not find graphics cards mostly anywhere. Let's just back it all the way up right now. 64 gigabytes of 3000 megahertz RAM, an 18-core Core i9 processor. Yeah, get that Extreme Edition going from Intel. So super fast performance, obviously for multi-threading stuff in particular.
We have now, is this three hard drive bays?
There's a whole bunch of hard drive bays here.
Okay.
There's only one in. This is a 6 terabyte hard drive. Mm-hmm. There's also, of course, a 1 terabyte SSD because you don't want to be booting onto a hard drive in this day and age.
Yeah, and then it looks like we have three optical drive bays too.
There's a whole lot of bays. So let me. Sasha, funny you should ask. Let's open up this front panel. There's one optical bay. Here, there's actually a DVD drive in this thing. That's really what the $9,000 is going towards. Is of course the DVD drive. But you can remove these also.
Does it have a PS2 port
and
too?
Add more. Yeah. Okay. Yes. So that's where those are hiding from the inside. You can Sasha spotted them, but that's how you get in.
Mm-hmm.
Power button. This strip lights up here. It's plugged in.
Now something I'm noticing. No front ports.
No front ports. They're up here. So they've kept it nicely, away.
I am not even tall enough to see the front ports on.
We have
computer.
A tall podium here, so yeah, that's mostly why. I turned it on. You get the strip going. The side panel is super easy to remove. It's just we actually took off because you can't pull it all the way away because there's fans mounted to the interior, so there's usually a wire running.
I unclipped the fans.
But we unclipped the fans from the header. Very simple to do. So you can just do two rear screws and remove the door. So it's really easy. You don't need like hassle. You don't need tools, which is also nice.
So now, can we get to the ports without this thing falling on the ground?
Let's find out.
Okay. Yeah.
Yeah. Plenty of port. I mean, it's USB ports for days.
Yeah, it's portastic.
Portastic back here.
Yeah. So we've got our four USB-A 3.0s. We've got what looks like four USB-A 2.1s. Oh, look, here's another three 3.0s. Why are these a different color?
They would be USB 3.1, but still Type A, and USB 3.
Whoa.
But still
okay,
Type A.
Okay. Dual Ethernet.
You never know. Look, people.
You never know when you might need a backup.
People have a lot of networks to attach to.
Okay. Hey, we've got some questions.
What type of motherboard is that?
Oh, it's in the review. I think it's the ASUS X399 Deluxe. Mm-hmm. Yeah, that sounds right. That sounds like a part.
Let me look down. Let me look down
it's
here and
a
see.
A little more. The parts are down there.
Okay.
X299 Deluxe. Wow, fire me now. I got the number one wrong by one.
Yeah,
$299 Deluxe.
We have a 1,000-watt power supply. Not the most powerful power supply we've seen recently.
No, though. We just had on the Origin Genesis.
13?
Yeah, it was a 1.3 kilowatt.
Yeah.
Yeah. But yes, this is enough to run. There's not a crazy closed loop liquid.
Yeah.
We do have a little customized nameplate. It says PC.
If anyone tries to steal your $9,000 PC, it's clear who to return it to.
Thank you, Falcon Northwest, for that.
Performance. Let's talk about performance, because this is all about performance.
Yeah, so this thing, as you would hope when you're paying this much, especially if the visual isn't all what you're buying it for, it's super fast. It set our fastest handbrake time ever. It broke 20 seconds. It's really, really
fast
at encoding video.
My jaw was on the floor about that.
That's kind of insane. Like, look at its Cinebench score compared to the iMac Pro, which is obviously an insanely expensive desktop. It's like 4 times as high. It's a little absurd. Yeah, so the clock speed on this is 4.4 gigahertz.
Yeah,
so.
And it's just a case of like, we talk a lot on this show about, you know, balancing your, you know, are you going for a CPU workload or a GPU workload and buying the appropriate PC for your workload? And you know what? This PC has all the workloads.
Any old workload, yeah. I would go as far as to say, yeah, this may be a gaming PC from Falcon Northwest. You probably want to play games on it. Buying this just for gaming would be an exercise in overkill.
The thing is, for gaming, nobody needs an i9.
No one needs an i9. No one needs an i. You really don't even need an i7 if you really are honest with yourself.
Uh-huh.
No one needs 2 Titan XPs, but if you're using it as a professional system for media creation stuff, there's no limit to how much speed helps you, really. So wait a minute, though.
The 2 Titan XPs, what can you output in terms of gaming frame rates, and how can you do in VR? How can you do at 4K?
I mean, it's well over 90 frames, even in 4K, 4K gaming. So like, it's a breeze. Uh-huh. VR is obviously easy to do.
Yeah.
Even one of these cars would be extremely impressive. We do have, you can pull up the 3D scores on there as well.
We've got some 3D scores here.
Almost 100 frames per second at 4K on
that is totally
heaven.
Ridiculous.
It's obscene.
It also looks like, it's the highest, is that the highest?
The highest Firestrike Extreme,
ever?
Which is, it's definitely up there, if not the highest, So it's setting some records. It's really, really fast, which is obviously what you'd hope for at this price range.
Now just a question, because I'm not like the world's greatest expert on graphics cards by far. Why is that Velocity Micro with the 2 1080 Ti's doing better than this guy at some
That's a good question.
Workloads.
I bet it has more to do with the tests than the cards, because they're obviously more powerful cards. They have an extra gigabyte of VRAM in addition.
Yeah.
The Firestrike Extreme score is probably the best measure of like raw 3D power there,
because
the others kind of like almost hit a ceiling. Like, you'll see the medium quality Valley test at 115 frames per second. There's just some weird conflict with the test. I did run it a couple times and it kept doing that. But rest assured, your real game frame rates will be highest with this.
Will be completely ridiculous with this.
Yeah, obscene.
Yeah, absolutely. Any more other questions out there?
I guess, what other computers does Falcon Northwest have right now?
I'm trying to think of their other desktops. They have a couple laptops. The thing
about Falcon Northwest, and here I'm stealing Buzzy's thunder.
Yes, go for
it. The thing about Falcon Northwest is that this is a $9,000 computer, but the Talon is anywhere from a $2,000 computer to a $9,000 computer.
Right. I can't off the top of my head right now pull out other case names, but yeah, it's more about the build and the size of the tower you're starting with.
Yeah.
From there, the computer can really be anything you want it to be, so they make it to order. The reason you go to a boutique vendor like that is because they ask what you want, they put it together for you, they do nice cable management work, everything's clean, everything is built and just sent to you. They give you support for years as far as helping you get new parts and shipping you new parts, and so that's another big reason. If you DIY your system, no one's there to help you if something goes wrong. It's all on you to fix it and troubleshoot, and if you need to buy new parts. Right now, especially with the graphics card market, it's kind of crazy that it's not even cheaper to DIY as far as graphics cards are concerned.
Yeah, because what happened is that these builders got lots of graphics cards, and by lots I don't mean many, I mean like a group of graphics cards. And so you may not be able to even get graphics cards on the open market at all that these builders still have some inventory.
Yeah, they have stuff in volume, so and you know. NVIDIA, I think, is trying to fight back and make sure retailers have cars to sell people, but mm-hmm. they're sitting on you know a lot of them because that's part of their business. It's a big part of their business. So, yeah.
But yeah, I mean, what it comes down to is that Falcon Northwest makes relatively few models of PC, but at the same time, very many models of PC.
Yeah, there's a couple archetypes you can kind of start as, and then spec your PC into different genres, classes, if you will. It's whatever you want to build, really, and whichever case you like the most. And then from there, including color, including parts, you go crazy. Another question.
So right now, people are having trouble finding video cards and just due to the cryptocurrency craze. Has that problem hit any of these pre-built makers yet?
Like Cesar was just saying, they probably have them or have had them in more volume before this need to snap them up, came flying in.
But I remember you saying the other day, actually, that the build prices have risen. Mm-hmm. That we're still, like, Falcon does not appear to be short of PC builds per se, but you said that some high-end machine we were looking at is $400 more expensive than
The price of the builds is fluctuating. They kind of have to, like, to give me a price even on what it's supposed to be, have to kind of wait to see what the cost actually is because of the market. So it does definitely affect them, even if they have them on hand. You still have to adjust them for the market, so you're making money still.
And so now we've been hearing about the graphics card shortage, but I was also hearing this morning about a RAM shortage as well.
I have not heard about the RAM shortage. Is there a big RAM crisis? Are the RAM going the way of the bees?
This was just something, I don't have the details. We were just discussing it offhandedly in the morning meeting this morning. Apparently the crypto miners, who are now just the devil.
Sure. Always have been, really.
Yeah, I mean, seriously. are apparently buying up all of the desktop RAM as well.
Ah, that makes sense. I mean, you need the part, the motherboards, the RAM, the graphics cards.
Right. And then, like,
I would think, yeah, I would think RAM would be a little easier to make and get, but, again, the Core i3, right?
Yes.
I guess watch out for rising RAM prices too.
Yeah, if there's a component shortage, going to these boutique builders is a good way around it, but you are going to pay a bit of a premium. There's no secret way to get cheap graphics cards and RAM.
Yeah, they can't
that
snap
nobody
their fingers
knows about.
Yeah. And make them appear.
Any more questions out there? Okay, so this Falcon Northwest Talon, I feel like talking about editor's choices when you're talking about a custom build that costs $9,000 is sort of, it's like a little frivolous.
Yes, where do you go? Where does the line stop, Sasha?
Exactly.
Where does the madness end?
Exactly. Like, I want, like, if I was paying $9,000, damn it, I would want the colored visible cooling.
Sure, yeah. That is something to consider. Some people like the more restrained. Some people just want something that's fast, especially if there's going to be a professional system. Maybe it's sitting around your office. Maybe it's sitting around at home.
It's like getting dusty under a desk. Doesn't matter.
It doesn't matter what it looks like. It's just a high performance. Not that it looks bad. I'm not, it's just not, a lot of these systems are made to be looked at specifically with crazy lighting and cooling. So the core of this system, the 18 cores of this system is the speed.
Yeah.
That is something to consider if you really want something flashy or you like the more restrained look. It is what it is.
So we like this for ultimate performance. We also like the Origin PC Genesis, I know.
Yep.
Although that has a slightly, like we described, that case is a little chintzy, I think.
It's looking, case had some issues. It is actually more expensive than this and slower, but part of that, I guess, is the look and aesthetic. So, like, no one's really going to make a value argument at this price range. It's not really the most important thing, but you are actually getting more speed for your buck out of this by actually a decent distance. So
if you want ultimate speed, this is a great build. It looks like we have one more question before we go.
With regards to the shortage for GPUs, why don't they just make more chips? Is there a material limit?
Why don't they just make more chips?
Yes.
I mean, you have to ramp up production. You have to, stuff is all, you can't just like
There's
make it
only
happen.
A certain number of GPU factories is the issue. And the factories are operating at their maximum capacity. So why don't they just make more chips? The answer is it takes years to build a plant to build these devices. We've been seeing, this is something I'm very, very familiar with, not from the GPU world, but from the issue of OLEDs, where for the past couple of years, actually, there's been essentially a global shortage of OLEDs because it is a great screen technology. Everybody wants them. TV people want them. Phone people want them, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. And last year, I was talking to LG, and they were like, yeah, we're building more OLED factories. Absolutely. It takes 2.5 years to build an OLED factory.
There you go.
So
AMD did just say it would ramp up its production, I believe, to try to fight back. But yeah, who knows how long that timeline is.
Yeah, but so the fact that, I mean, this graphics card shortage has only been going on for, what, 3 months? Mm-hmm. For a couple months.
It's hard to, like, snap your fingers and turn around more volume.
And so the answer is basically just that the market is nimbler than the ability of the factories to go above their previous maximum levels of production. That's all.
Indeed.
So thank you all for watching. This has been One Cool Thing. We will be back tomorrow on Facebook at 10 a.m. Eastern with another cool thing. If you are on YouTube, please like and subscribe. You can check back tomorrow on YouTube where we'll have another video, or come over to Facebook if you want to join the discussion.